Welcome to the second part of Y-Panel Eden video series. In this video, I will explain about pen slots. What's so special about pen slots is, it can behave like a layer manager of 2D software like Photoshop, but in 3D view. Here are the hot links to quickly jump to the part you want to watch. A pen slot in Blender actually means an image texture with UV map. So if your model doesn't have UV map yet, pen slot subpanel just shows a button to add simple UVs. Just keep in mind, this is quick unwrap, so the result might not be perfect. Before continuing, make sure you use material shading to see how the pen slots works in the 3D view. You can create a blank pen slot using this button. Then, influence selection will appear. For now, let's just choose diffuse color. After that, the image dialog box will show up. For the diffuse color influence, the default color is transparent. Let's just click OK. Newly created image will immediately show up on this list and the image editor. Now you can just go to texture paint mode and start painting. You can also add pen slot from available image. For example, if you want to load this grid image, you can click this button, type the image name, then click OK. If you want to delete a pen slot, you can just press this button. Next, you can also load from your hard drive. Just click this folder icon. Let's add a couple more pen slots and paint them. Notice that lower pen slot overlaps upper pen slot. That's because Blender pen slot's order is top to bottom, compared to the more common bottom to top order like on Photoshop. To make pen slots more like a layer manager, I also added functionality like move up, move down, and merge up. You can access influence vector below the pen slots list. You can see this pen slot only have one influence, which is diffuse color. You can add more influence to a pen slot by using this plus button. Let's try the specular color. You might not notice the effect, but if I disable the diffuse color, now you can see the painted area has colored specular. Let's enable the diffuse color again. Next, let's try to add bump influence. You can see now the pen slot also produces bump effect. It looks weird because transparent pen slot messes up the bump effect. So let's just remove this influence. To clearly see bump effect in action, just create a new bump pen slot. Notice that the default color is solid black. Now you can just paint the bump map. You can add diffuse color influence and set the RGB to intensity to add color layer on top of the bump effect. Notice there's a ball icon on the right of the bump influence. because Blender shares bump and normal parameter, is to toggle between bump and normal map. This pen slot is not a normal map, so the shading will look all over the place. I will show you how to create a normal map in the back tools video. Below influence is settings for blending, which is similar to the layer blending for Photoshop or GIMP. Then it's followed by UV map name. The default is empty, which means it uses whatever UV map currently active. As usual, you can find more advanced settings for blending and UV map inside the gear buttons. Because of how Blender behaves, you will lose your image if you don't save them. Notice there's star sign beside the pen slot name. It's to indicate this pen slot hasn't been saved yet. You can choose to save or save as. If you are just like me, rather than saving every pen slot, I feel like it's more practical to just pack the pen slots inside the blend file by using this button. Notice now there's a pack icon beside the pen slot name. It's to indicate the pen slot is packed inside the blend file. Just don't forget to pack the file again if you did some changes on the pen slot. If you want to quickly pack and save all the pen slots, you can just use Save All button. Pen slot subpanel is built upon slot sidebar that can only be accessed on the texture pane mode. With some hacks, I managed to get this subpanel works not only on the texture pane mode. But the drawback is, sometimes there's a need to refresh the pen slots. It will noticeably happen often after doing undo. With Y-panel pen slots, I hope painting using Blender can be more convenient. On the next video, I will explain about material override, which can be useful to test your pen slots influence, so be sure to check it out. If you like my works, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Thanks for watching and see you on the next video.